Hi, I'm Dave Filoni, and welcome to TV Guide Magazine's exclusive sneak peek at Star Wars The Clone Wars. This disc features interviews, clips, and special behind-the-scenes features of The Clone Wars, coming out August 15th in a theater near you. We've also got some special surprises that show you the future of The Clone Wars. So, thanks for picking up this special TV guide, and welcome to the world of Star Wars The Clone Wars. Welcome to Lucasfilm Animation. This is where we make the Clone Wars series. This is my office. I'm sure you all wonder what kind of toys we all have in our office. Well, you're right. We have a bunch just like you do. You'll see a bunch of around the studio. I'm going to introduce you to the fantastic crew of extremely talented people that have been making the Clone Wars for the past 2 years. So let's go talk to some of them. This is Andrew Harris, my CG supervisor.
Hello. Hello, Jason Tucker. Nice to meet you. I'm the supervising editor.
Hi, guys.
Hey, guys.
Hello. Hey, fans.
You have notes from George, huh?
Notes from George.
Athena, say hello to the fans.
Hello. Greetings.
Renee. Over here we've got Steve. He's working on some really cool stuff that he's not allowed to show you, right, Steve?
Right.
Back here is Angie. If you could see this side of her screen, she's got some really cool images happening, but not going to show you that today, right, Angie?
That's right.
Young Matt Gaser. This shows his problem with TIE Fighter since the beginning, so a little obsession, but we love that here. John modeled Plo Koon for me, so I'm forever in debt to John.
My name is Pun, Leander
Cannon. I'm Kieran Ritchie.
Justin.
Yeah.
Been with us since the very beginning. He was here before I got here.
Hi, I'm Eddie. I'm part of the assistant technical directing team.
Hi, I'm Greg Ricks.
Hi, my name is Pouchon Venet.
Hello, my name is Dave.
My name's James Berkheimer.
I'm Steve Parker.
I'm Mark Therrell.
We are working on the Jedi Cruiser.
So I'm just gonna check in with the producers of Clone Wars, the high level stuff, see what they're doing. Well, hey guys, here you have the producers of the Clone Wars. They're like very important stuff going on. They're probably talking about money and budget. I don't concern myself with those things, so, yeah. I was told not to by the master. That's a rule. Why don't you introduce yourself and tell them who you are?
Jules Beasley, the assistant editor.
What are you up to, Jules?
I'm Nick Anastasio, and I'm one of the editors on The Clone Wars.
Hi, I'm Chris.
Hi, I'm Lauren. I am the animation and retake coordinator.
Gary.
Howdy.
Say hello to all the Star Wars fans.
Hello.
Hey, Star Wars fans. I'm Stuart Lee. I'm a storyboard artist on Clone Wars.
Hey, guys. John L. Farmer.
Yeah.
Working here on something called Star Wars, Clone Wars.
Hello, Star Wars fans.
Close up.
I'm Trish.
I'm Michelle Yost, layout story previous supervisor.
Hello.
Hi, I'm Bosco.
I'm Doug Price, layout artist.
I'm Roman Yepes, one of the 3D storyboard artists.
And Dan, introduce yourself.
3D storyboard artist.
He claims that he was Kit Fisto.
My name is Jackie, I'm a 3D storyboard artist.
Hey, I'm Sergio.
Hi. I'm Justin. I'm a Cancerian. I like meeting people, going to parties, reading books.
Lee, story artist.
Hi. I'm Megan. I am Dave's assistant.
So, that about wraps up our tour of Skywalker Ranch, Big Rock location. May the Force be with you. Thanks a lot. One thing to consider in the battles of the Clone Wars, the fighting styles of the Jedi, the sword play that's going to go on, and there will be a lot of it. You watch the films and the lightsaber fighting just kept getting bigger and bigger and better. So each Jedi should have their own technique and their own style. Mace Windu, his style was expressed a little bit when he fights Palpatine and when he fights and attacks the clones. With Ahsoka and coming up with her fighting style, she uses a reverse grip. And we wanted to give her some unique traits in her own fighting style.
Have you ever fought one of these things before?
We played with the idea really early on of that being a side effect of prior teaching for Ahsoka. So when Anakin got his Padawan, that she would already have some type of training and some type of style. You also notice with her fighting style, she's very evasive and she's quick and she's cat-like. Because of her size, we wanted her to be very nimble. It makes her a little more animalistic than we've seen, you know, Anakin Skywalker could ever be. But as her fighting style progresses, she also starts to carry her sword more like Anakin and behave at some times more like Anakin, which is also interesting and fun to play with as well.
The interesting thing about the Clone Wars is that in the normal course of the Skywalker saga, it's not told. It's skipped over. We have a little bit of the beginning in episode 2, and then we have a little bit of the end in episode 3. But we never get into the details of what happens during the war. Obviously, during a war, there's lots and lots of stories. Very exciting action, drama, heartbreak, and comedy. This idea of doing a animated TV series was intriguing to me because it really did allow me to broaden the canvas of what Star Wars is about.
Hi, Dave Filoni here again. Not only are we excited about the Clone Wars movie, we're thrilled to have the Clone Wars series debuting on the Cartoon Network this fall. Here's an exclusive look at Ahsoka, the newest member of the Star Wars universe, and a pivotal character in the series.
Stay close to me, if you can.
Anakin Skywalker, having a Padawan is a very new thing to people. This has never been heard of or seen. What type of Jedi Knight would Anakin have been to a Padawan? How would he teach her? What would he teach her? What is the effect of Anakin Skywalker's teaching on a young Jedi pupil? Is it what the Jedi Council expected it to be? In the end, Anakin has a Padawan to teach him about attachments. Yoda and the Jedi Council are hoping that by having an attachment to a pupil, much like Anakin had an attachment to his mother, that Anakin will one day learn as Ahsoka grows and becomes more powerful and strong on her own and becomes more independent, that he can learn to let her go. This is something Anakin has to learn because he attaches to his mother. He's very attached to these droids that he has. He has an attachment and an affinity for a certain senator that he's met. Even to his own master, Obi-Wan Kenobi, he displays quite a lot of attachment, and that makes it dangerous because the Jedi have to be aware of the jeopardy the Chosen One has. And when Anakin learns to let the student go, he will become a Jedi Master.
Contact with General Kenobi.
Kidnapped. Jabba the Hutt's son has been. Negotiate the treaty with Jabba. Obi-Wan will. Find the renegades that hold Jabba's son. Your mission will be, Skywalker.
Redlock, stand by.
Soon the Jedi will not only be at war with you, Count, but the Hutt clan as well.
They have nowhere to run.
Trouble! Everything is going as planned.
Yes, my lord.
Anakin, we are vastly outnumbered.
Now it's your turn, Master.
Oh, dear.
Skywalker is the Republic's only hope.
Where is Skywalker?
Hang on!
Ahsoka!
You failed, Jedi.
Now you die.
This is where the fun begins.
Race you to the top.
I'll give you a head start.
Your mistake.
Attention cables!
I'm right behind you, Master!
Whoa! Target those whackers!
Well, this should be fun.
Yeah.